gospel of this Sunday is about the great commandment, love of God and love of neighbor. But I ask myself what it is to love God with all my heart, mind and strength. Surely, it involves giving first place to God. What happens when we give first place and when God truly occupies the first place in our lives? All burdens become light. All choices are made for Him. All spontaneous and deliberate tendencies and actions regard Him. The summarized command of Jesus to love God and neighbor is given in a particular order. God takes precedence. What hinders us from obeying this command of love? The first one is absolutizing material things as God, like modern gadgets. Secondly, finding meaning in people rather than setting aside primacy due to God. And third, putting ourselves in God's place, perhaps the most dangerous temptation of all. In the Gospel, we are asked by Jesus Himself to equate duty to God as duty to our neighbor. And God no longer has an independent identity. The whole idea here is the collapse of the first commandment of loving God into the second commandment of loving our neighbor. When asked what love of God means, and the immediate response invariably is love of God is love of neighbor. Though it may seem it an utopian to love God, it touches upon our being human much before it helps us arrive at God. Perhaps the so-called discerning God's will is seeing the immediate need of my neighbor. If one is sincere about being in love with God, I suppose my neighbor would certainly be not left out to himself or herself. For as religious, God is not something we postulate for some practice of vows, but only in Him we love our neighbor, serve Him in our neighbor. On this last day of the month of Rosary, let us intercede our dear mother who loved God and loved neighbor to help us to get freed of our own selfish motives, cultivate that filial love for God, and be generous in our dealings with one another.